So after a very strange year for us all, I think BACD overall, we were very happy the way everything went. And we worked hard out here in the Enterprise Centre to maintain our occupancy levels and worked with all our clients to help everyone through COVID. So it was one of the biggest projects that we undertook, which we got the best reaction or amazing reaction out of, was the Christmas lights and the support that we got from the full community, both near and far, people buying tickets and people sending messages and people out on the streets with our new lights, which was a huge boost for everyone, which is fantastic. And I suppose the third major thing that we're very proud of this year is the Ballinasloe Life and the fact that we were able to keep it going even through COVID. We were able to support all our advertisers and keep the magazine going through the strange times we found ourselves in. So overall, I think we did have a successful year and we're looking forward to expanding into next year.
At our recent AGM, we set some priorities for the year ahead. Firstly and foremost, we want to complete the purchase of the Bank Chambers on Society Street, renovate that, have it fully completed and fully occupied by the end of next year, that's by 2022. And we're on track to do that. Secondly, as a result of opening up the second premises, we want to make sure that we retain occupancy levels here in the Enterprise Centre. Thirdly, we've done a lot of groundwork on a 10-year plan. Currently well on the way through that. That needs to be completed. And hopefully when things open up, we'll be able to have a gathering in Galans or the Shearwater here in town, where we can get people in, get their views on it, and finally ratify it. There's ongoing work in regard to the Town Enhancement Scheme, and we want to ensure that the Shopfront Enhancement Scheme is completed and all our shop fronts are painted and cleaned up, and that the town will be looking well at the end of the summer when we're open up to the general public again. A lot of you may not be aware of the amount of money that has been allocated to Ballinasloe, but there's been a huge amount of funding allocated here from various sources. We have the Board of Works, which are doing the Flood Relief Scheme. The Hidden Heartlands have allocated money for which we'll be entitled to a cut. Transport Infrastructure Ireland have their offices set up here in Ballinasloe. And work in regards to the Greenway will be announced later in the year. Waterways Ireland have money allocated. The Department of Education are building a new town school here, and hopefully we'll have good news on St Teresa's later in the new year. In the year. HSE, are, as we all know, are building a 50-bed unit in the hospital and spending quite substantial ground there on the complex as well. Galway County Council have funding set aside to develop the rear of Main Street and Society Street. Hopefully we'll see progress on that before the end of the year. Éireann have announced funding for the upgrade of the railway station. There's ongoing talk in regard to Bridges Hospital. A private company are looking at developing that site. Hopefully that will progress during the summer. And we in BACD are spending, well, it'll cost us the guts of $800,000 to renovate and get the premises up on Main Street. And then there's private enterprise going on as well. Like, we have the distillery in Ahaskra. There'll be $8 to $10 million of a spend on that. There's a new housing development, planning permission in place for that. Hopefully now that the economy is opening up again, that we'll see progress there. KPW are expanding, and various other private enterprises. So the outlook is good, but that all needs to be coordinated. And that's one big thing that we will be driving through BACD, that we have a task force in place to coordinate all of these things, to make sure we get value for money and that the town looks good as a result of it. So there's a lot happening, a lot going on, a lot of work to do. And just before I finish off, I just want to thank the directors for their attendance at meetings throughout the year and their constructive contributions throughout the year. So here's looking forward to a good finish for the rest of this year and looking forward to 2022. Thank you very much.